Hey y'all, it's Crazy Excite here, and I'm bringing you this quick little video just to clear up some stuff that's been going on recently. We recently had a clan battle with a clan called Play. We actually had it last night, and we won in the end, 2-1, and they're putting up some videos saying we didn't, and they don't have any proof of it, and I'm going to show you guys some proof that we did. Alright, so we're just going to start here. We're going to go in the video of the order of the Skype conversation. They started out, you guys can read all that. And he was complaining that we played a CTF game, and we had four guys, and they had three. Now, let me just say, this is going in the order of the Skype conversation. All right, so this is a CTF game. This is after all three clan battles were held. So after all three clan battles were held, everything was done. We just wanted to go have a friendly game of CTF. We didn't even say they had to stay. We were just going in for us, and they joined, and that's fine. And then they all left, and they're trying to use this to accuse us that we cheated or something. I don't really understand it, since this was after the fact of all three clan battles. And now we're going to move on to the next point, and the next point they make is almost as funny. They're saying that, you guys can read this again, that he got three hit markers with the MSR, the L11, on lockdown, and so that makes it okay for him to use an MP7 to get three kills. Now, let me just explain something. The way that he gets these three kills that you're going to see is absolutely insane. Even if we were okay with him getting three MP7 kills, he gets all three kills right when we capture the headquarters while they're losing. This is the last game, mind you. This is the tiebreaker game. He gets all three, killing all three of our guys who just captured the headquarters so they could uncapture it. If it was a random three kills he got, he wouldn't have done it right then. He would have done it some other time. He would have got one kill at a time. He sprayed all three of us as we were in the headquarters, and we still get final kill cam. So get at me, bro. We won that game. This was the last game that we played, but again, I'm just going in the order of the Skype conversation that we were having. And this is me leaving the lobby. He sent me a message that said DQ, so for those of you that don't know what that means, is disqualification. He's saying, I thought originally he was, like, admitting to a disqualification because he got three kills in a row with an MP7 destroying our headquarters. But apparently he meant it as in, we were disqualified because we rage quit. A rage quit is not what you do when you're up by 100 and some points and they start pulling out MP7s. That is what's called reason. That is called a normal reaction to something ridiculous. We're not going to waste our time with that. So here's the next part. Absolutely delightful. Again, you guys can read this, and he was talking about the map we lost in Dome. Now look, see, it does say loss right there, and now I'm going to show you why it says that. It was because at the end of the game, I was spectating their team, and they said that we ended the game, and like, we raged. We weren't the host of the game, they were the host of this game, and I wasn't even playing. And there, see, we're spectating Cray Zap on the Cray side, we're winning. Looks like 160-0. Alright, so we're winning 160-0, and you guys saw me take this right out of the theater. This is not edited, this is exactly what it is. It's in the theater, it's in there, I didn't move it, put it in my file share, nothing has changed about it, it's just raw footage as it was, and we're still watching, and see, now we switch to the other team, and it's showing the loss, and now we switch back to Crazed, and it's showing the W again, the win. And now it's going to happen here in a second. See, we're spectating Crazed. Now I switched it. Now we're spectating Play. And I pause it down just so you guys see that differentiation. Now the game ends right there. You know why the game ends for me? Because it kicked me out. I lagged out. And I was just spectating and I lagged out of the game. And then a few seconds after that, guess what happened? The rest of the Crazed guys ended up in my lobby. They went and they joined my lobby because they were also kicked out of the game. The connection was that bad. And if you really want, I will post another video slowing this down, showing all of the lag from it. Now this, oh wow, he has the audacity to tell me that he will post our losses and show them to the internet. They were playing against an empty lobby. We were all gone from the game. I don't even know how it ended because I wasn't there anymore. We weren't even there. He could have made up the score. He could have said it was 500-160 because I think we were like 160-20 when we left. And then what is he going to prove? What does he have to prove anything? I am the one making this video with actual video in it. I will use images. I will use facts. No one is going to come and disrespect my clan like that and just put up blatant lies, blatant fallacies about us and think that they can get away with it. It's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous. Oh, now this is classic. This is the game they won. Out of the three games, this is the game they won. And so I was just going through, looking for some good clips to make a montage with, and I see this! He's using a goddamn tactical insurgent! We said, fine, you can make your own classes after they bitched about it for like an hour. We said you can make your own classes, just none of that crap, no steady aim, no portable radar, no tactical insurgents, heartbeat sensors, and he's using a tactical insurgent! And you can see it right there, and you can see it glowing in the corner when I go back on it right here, as he's walking past it. Play's using them. Oh! Again, look at this. A second tactical insertion. Now, please look at the score. 0 points have been scored yet. He is already doing this crap before any points have been scored. He is preemptively being a douchebag. And this is just some... This actually looks kind of cool. I like this free roam kind of thing. Because I locked it differently that I could do this game, which was fun. Ugh. But they did win this game. And you know what? I was just so sick when I saw the tactical insertions, I couldn't even go watch the rest of it because I was afraid of how many others I would find. This is ridiculous. Oh, and then this. Look at this. All right, so we're Crazed Josh. All right, expecting Crazed Josh. He gets a little quick scope right there. And then look what happens. Look what happens when this guy comes out of the door. He gets a hit marker. And you know what he doesn't do? He doesn't pull out an automatic like a little bitch. All right, he just plays the damn game. And he gets on with it. And he does what he's supposed to do. And he does what he has to. Pulling out an MP7 because he got a hit marker. Grow up. This is sped-up gameplay of the real Dome Headquarters game, the one that everyone was in for the entirety of it. I was actually eating in the beginning, so I came in late just to spectate, and it was close. It was a nail-biter. I mean, they were all close games. They were all good games. These guys aren't bad, but they're giant dicks, and they just make shit up. It's ridiculous, especially when somebody like me, I'm pretty clever. I can figure one out when they're lying, especially when I was in the games, and I can record this stuff, and I can put it on the internet as a response to theirs and as something of my own. All right? Now, this is the one. We won that. All right? And here's a scoreboard bringing it up. They switched out one player at one time, so we did as well. That's why two of the guys on either side have really low scores. And I think on last time on C-Town, if you saw two guys on our team with low scores, actually, I'll just bring up the image again right here so I don't get bitched out in the comments for it. Crazed Jester and Crazed Zap switched out at one point. In this, you might not want to look at this if you're, you know, a little frayed of heart or whatever, because he's such an asshole. So this is a summary. This is a perfectly concise, clear summary. This is what happened. There's his, you know, coin little comment in the bottom left-hand corner. Him putting down two tacks before we'd scored any points. No points were scored yet. There are the two victories in the top right and the bottom left. Their YouTube channel in the top left, and the MP7 triple feed in the bottom when we had the headquarters captured. This has been Crazed Excite and TTFN!